Today on Uncommonly Good MTG, we're playing Rakdos Calamity deck. It was just released from Tay Malice, and I'm looking forward to it because this thing looks rocking. Looks like we got a little bit of some card draw, finding our way into some big gigantic dudes who like to be copied. If that sounds interesting to you, then stay tuned to find out more. Hello and welcome to Uncommonly Good MTG. I am your host. I gotta tell you that while I'm not superstitious, I might be a little stitious. Dr. Yukon Suckett! Yes, thank you! Film before a live studio audience. Thank you so much, Yukon Suckett! Word to your mama. So I'm broadcasting to you today from my secret underground headquarters, and I'm bringing to you a deck I found over on the Aether Hub, hosted by Tay Malice, called Rakdos Calamity. So yeah, this, I remember, I love Rakdos. I love Rakdos. Black and red, always a fun time. That's a party color. And moreover, Calamity, the Galloping Inferno. This card is a fantastic card, and there's been a tournament-type deck that's done very well. I think it had three colors in it. This one is fighting with two. So let's see what Tay Malice has got for us today. What we're going to do, we're going to take a look at the cards in this deck. We'll talk a little bit about how the deck should work. And we'll go out and we'll crush some hopes and dreams. All right, what do we got? We got Creature Kill, Card Draw, Board Wipe of things with three. It does 3 points of damage to each creature and each Planeswalker, or destroys all artifacts with a mana value of three or left. So a limited board draw, but it's an early game at three mana, so it helps out a lot. Card draw and a little bit of treasure creation. This guy does damage equal to the power of any creature that you put into play. This guy, anytime a creature dies, your opponent loses two life, you gain two life. This guy can be used as a 3 point for three. 3 points of damage for three, but you can do damage to creatures or planeswalkers. Or when it enters the battlefield, you discover five. And five would be Terror of the Peak on over, right? So not big on creatures, but maybe Terror of the Peak. You never know. Lastly, we got Calamity, who, whenever you saddle up something, then you create like two copies of it that turn that disappear at the end of the turn. So then we got Push as well, which you want to use the pull. The pull will return two target cards from a graveyard to the battlefield under your control. And then you gain haste until the end of the turn. You sacrifice them at the end of the next turn. So the deal is that you can throw a bunch of dudes in the graveyard and then pull them back with pull. And then if you got Calamity out, you can make two copies of any one of them you want. You make two copies of the Carnosaur, you get to discover two times. If you make two copies of Terror of the Peaks, you're shooting 10 points of damage around. If you put out two copies of Vein Ripper, then any creature that dies, then you'll gain six and they'll lose six if something dies. And since at least two of your guys would die, the two that you created, that means that it'll be what, six per each? No, it'll be six. It'll be 12, because each of them will die and each of them causes each other to fire off a number of times. I'm not really sure how the math works out there. It could be a lot. So anyways, making duplicates of awesome guys is almost always a great way to go, and that's what this deck wants to do. Over here, we got some man lands, and we got a little bit of scrying, and we got the ability to put out some hasty little spirits and the ability to bring guys back from the graveyard. Some more graveyard recursion as well. Fantastic. All right, so what are we going to do? We're going to control the board. We're going to draw cards, throw out some additional treasure, and then try to hopefully slam down some calamities and start copying big guys. We can do that. There's pretty much nobody that can stand up to our awesome universal power, and we'll just floor them into out of existence. All right, so that's it. But before we can do our damage, let's do as we do every night. Let's say our prayers and talk about what is best in life. Hands together. Dear Black King Toxrel, who dwells within the dark chambers of my heart, please hear my prayers and grant your blessings as we attempt to crush our enemies, see the driven before us, and to hear the lamentations of the women. All right, we're playing against Rimsjik. Keep. That's a lot of Blackleaf Cliffs. Oh, nothing to do till 4. All right, we got a 2. Let's throw away the Trumpeting Carnosaur. Lots of mana. All we can do is go search the next turn. Might throw something away. Probably a land at this point. Alright, 4. Let's get rid of the Vein Ripper. Ooh, nothing but lands, though. That is rough. Alright, well, I guess I could put out Terror of the Peaks. And slaughter everybody on his side. You'll probably kill it, though, is the problem. Let's try. All right, here we go for 5. Good enough. All right, let's just pretend that we don't have anything cool going on. Don't kill it, don't kill it, don't kill it, don't kill it. Unfortunately, he can now blow his... Does he have the mana? No, he just has to sacrifice it. Dang it! I said no! We don't have the stack we need. Could have just gone for his face, but this will be fine. Victory! All right, we're playing against Vacant. The vacant stare in his eyes indicated that there was not a brain back there. Keep it. Yeah, there's nothing I can do for 1. Let's see. So I can put out a slow one. Two. There he is, Trumpeting Carnosaur. All right, that's cool. Three, nothing worth doing yet. I mean, I could blow that thing away, right? Yep, I can use it to see what kind of artifacts he puts out. That's an artificer, cool. You don't got anything else going on, man. All right, here's number 4. We're cool. We're just building up. So I'm guessing I'll play the Carnosaur at some point. I'll just go ahead and kill it. Kill something. Then I can pull it back using pull. I have to sacrifice him. That's bad. That's bad, MK. One, two, three, four, five. Nothing. That guy cost me six. Yeah, Calamity's the guy I think I wanted to hold on my hand. Getting rid of him early might not have been a great idea. Should I take my time? Should I just blow this guy away? All right, he's got a single mana. Does he have the ability to non-creature spells? Oh, come on, man. You're an artifact, aren't you? Oh, he's an artificer. Entirely different thing. Alright, he's not playing counter spells. That's good. Otherwise, he would have countered that guy. You gotta sacrifice a creature if you want to touch him. All you could do would be bounce. Well, he's got another one of those. Nuts. You want to sacrifice a guy? Yeah, I'd back off of that one. All right, we're all sitting here talking. I could do a pull next turn. It'll be fun. It'll be lots of fun. You don't want to do it. You can sacrifice your own guy if you really want to tap him. You just tap that. All right, here we go. I'm thinking it might be time to just go ahead and blow dudes away. Another Brotherhood's End. Yeek! I can't blow that guy away. Can't take him with Vane Ripper. That's probably the best course of action. All right, let's do this. All right, that's it. You gonna give up your disruptor? Yeah. All right, that's two dudes. That's four Delta. I know I could have popped Terror of the Peaks. I could have. That is disappointing. That Discover looks really good. I'm going to get out Terror first. Is that what I'm going to do? Sweet googly. I'm being too greedy at this point. All right, come on, let's just get this over with. Come on. All right, come on, we can do this. Hold it together. Okay, I'm gonna have to kill this final dude the old-fashioned way. All right, there you go. Now top deck some stuff. You can start balancing some things. Not cool. Not cool. I'll just go for it. Whatever. Here we go. Fortunately, you can bounce. You can bounce the right guys. We're kind of screwed here. You want to bounce Calamity, man. Cool, I get him back. Would I have to saddle him? Huge mistake on my part there. Oh, I made so many mistakes right there. I still won. Oh, that was ridiculous. All right, playing against Humble Beast. Humble Beast. I like it when you can pronounce your name. Keep. All right, Vein Ripper. We got recursion somewhere. We start attacking with our man land in another turn if we need to. Or I can go for big score. And we're done. All right, we can put out Terror of the Peaks next turn, no problem. That is bad. It's kind of okay. We just got to keep the Calamity back. All right, that's fine. We're going to go ahead and pop it. Pop this guy, that is. All right, in for five. Go get him. All right, so next turn. I thought he was going to Urza it. Silex it right now. But apparently he's putting dudes out. Haste! All in, baby cakes. And I forgot to saddle him. I always forget for that. I'm just so excited, I forget to saddle it up. And now we're about to lose everything, except for I can just bring him back on the next turn. Float away. Thank you. We want Calamity, and let's go for Damage Boy. Shot to the face. And unfortunately, we don't have any mana, so we just have to do it the old-fashioned way. Victory! Alright, we're playing against Entropy. Kill, kill, bit of reunion. If another mana always sounds good right now. I'm gonna do this. I've been throwing away the big guys, but I always feel like that might be a mistake. Pay two life, huh? Do I really care? I guess I do a little bit. This guy's trying to prowess me. All right, he's out of mana. Hopefully he's out of guys. Alright, next turn I get out Terror of the Peaks. It's hard to believe he's playing that with slow lands. Plus, what has he got? Green in there then? He's not even looking for it. You have the ability to shoot it for four. All right. Apparently he's given up. Oh, it was a slow land. All right, man. I'm just pushing attack buttons here. Punch a rock in the face. Come on, we can do it. Oink. Oink. There we go. Hey there, Q-Bert. Nothing to put it off the saddle, so we're just going to go in. Are you going to be able to shoot it for six? I really doubt it. Hopefully we can pick up another creature. I mean, I can use big score. Lately I've been using big scores in this deck. I get lands. Two of them. I don't like my mono red. The chance of Meal to throw seven in my face. I mean, obviously he can't do it, but I mean, these things go crazy sometimes. An instant? All right. We have to big score it. We'll have two mana. Plus two more. Great. Just leave it. And for four. Here we come. If everything works out well, it'll be maximum overkill on our next turn. Question is, this guy going to be able to do 7 in one turn? It's very probable. It only takes another, what, 2 more mana to shoot me, and I'm dead? And we win. All right, no lightning strike. Winner, winner, victory dinner. All right, we're playing against Klaus. Rhymes with blouse. Yeah, I only kept the 2 mana because of Bitter Reunion. Look what you did to my map, man. That's not cool. Trick or treat. All right, there's push pull. We need 6 mana for that. Bane Ripper 6. There's 3. Let's try this again. Okay, we got another Brotherhood's End. These guys are 3s. Alright, I got to Bitter Triumph this guy. Alright, we need a 4th mana. Like, it's jumping beyond my ability to do damage to pretty quickly is the problem. 4 comes in slow. We'll just have to kill him. And he's got yet another. And obviously he's going to jump up to 4 immediately. All right, we just nailed that guy. That's all we can do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, if we get a mana, we're really lucky. We got one. Is it fast? It's slow, so it sucked. And nothing. We just got to take the damage still. I'm going to play this for a slow price right there. Still, 3 is not going to do me any good. All right, you can come at me. You can get at least 2 through. and that'll pump it up, and I can't do anything about it. Apparently I can do something about it. Gone! Ooh, skin of my teeth! Do I want to take it? Don't pump it. I'm trying to be tricksy. What's next on the top there? Saddle up. There we go. Yes. All right, apparently that's what we're gonna do. Ooh, we traded for lands. How fantastic. And that's that. All right. So I do have the ability to block another guy. Hopefully he doesn't know it. Rage, rage into the night. You don't have haste, man, so I think we got this sewn down. That is bad. All right, so we're losing Terror of the Peaks. Not a great thing, but I have no choice. Okay, that guy's gone. Saddle up. That's two discovers we get out of the deal. And we win! In your face, Davy Jones! Victory! All right, here we are playing Rakdos Calamity. And I was pleased. I thought it was a great deck. One of the things I liked about it was the fact that it is rotation-proof. That's what I'm trying to do this month. I'm trying to go more rotation-proof. And this thing looks like it is rotation-proof. That guy's not. So it's just some lands. So, when I checked it out earlier, all these cards, these guys are all rotation-proof. It's just the lands you got to deal with here, and that's not so bad. All right, so not entirely rotation-proof. I'm going to try to focus on that more, but here we go. Was this deck fun? Yeah, it was a great deck. I really liked it. I like Calamity. I thought that was a good deck. I remember playing it like a couple weeks ago or something. It was cool. I'm still trying to get used to what's the best strategy with Calamity, because I always think it like pulls things out of the graveyard. It doesn't. But if you have it out and then you pull things back and it's out there when you attack, then it can make use of the guys that you just pulled back from the graveyard. So I got to remember that. Plus, you also have to saddle it up, which I forget a lot. So there's a lot of little things. It's not an automatic feature of him. You got to pay for it and cost one guy to be tapped to be able to do it. Other than that, though, the guys you do pick are really great. The question is it okay to throw your guys in the graveyard? Yeah, provided you can get yourself to pull, because you really need pull to be able to pull your guys back from the graveyard. Otherwise, you're just throwing away great guys. You do have ramp when it comes to big score, because it gives you that two extra mana. But it just felt like I was paying for these guys full price anyway, because they cost six. It cost six to put out the Calamity. I was paying full price for everything. So why did I really care about throwing them in the graveyard? It wasn't really helping me out. It just, if you had pull, it was like, great, throw away your guys because you can just pull them out for six. You get two guys for just a second, you know, for that one turn. It was kind of a weird situation. But it was still fun. It still played. It did a little bit over 50%. So let's just do the count up here. Number one, who was the MVP? Who was the most valuable player? The most valuable player to me was Calamity. Yep. I mean, all the rest of this is just trying to find the good cards. This one gives a tiny bit of control. This one gives you a little bit more control. But you're just trying to raid your way up to Calamity because you want to be able to duplicate your guys. All your guys are great, but you know what's even better than one version of them? Like three versions of them. That's what's really great. So Calamity, you are the MVP of this particular deck. Congratulations. It's not the flaming guy in the back. It's the horse. All right, you're going to Dizzyland. Was this deck competitive? Barely. I pulled this thing out at 53%. What was the big problem with this deck? The big problem with this deck was that it took a long time to come to fruition. I could get two and then put this out where I was looking for other cards, or I can get to four where I could put this out and get other cards. And even then, it was a crapshoot. Most of the times, I seemed to get more land. I guess it wasn't this one. It was this one at four, right? So it's just like, I really needed to get these guys over here. And a lot of times, they seemed to hide. A lot of them I couldn't get. You don't need much. Three of them, one Calamity, one of each of the others. You know, if you can get another one, you can throw into a graveyard or something. It all works great. So it doesn't take much. It takes until you get to six to really make this thing to come together. Big score will get you those extra two, so maybe you could play it by your fifth turn. But you're really doing nothing for a long period of time. Bitter Triumph and Brotherhood's End are what you could do, but even then, that's just control. And if people are playing super aggro decks, it's not enough to fight them back. A little bit. You're lucky, but you know, it'll probably give you maybe a 60% chance of making it. Well, you still got a 40% chance of getting your ass beat. So that's my problem with this deck with percentage-wise, is that it still takes a long time to come to fruition. All right, so was it competitive? I'm going to say it was competitive enough to play, but it's not competitive enough to win ranked ladder. Let's put it that way. Number two, was this deck fun? Yeah, it was fun. I mean, my problem with it is it wasn't aggro enough at first, but it did give you a little bit of early game control, which makes up for a lot. What I do like is big score, if you can get it, will jump you up to six, and at six, the deck comes together very nicely. It just says you got to wait till turn five until you could potentially make all this stuff happen, and that is rough. And sometimes you falter out at three, and that was not great. So, yeah, it was a fun deck, but there was a lot of opportunities for things to just sort of deflate. Lastly, was this deck interesting? Yeah, reason why is because it was a Rakdos version of Calamity. I thought before I was playing something that was more with green in it as well. I don't quite remember what it was. Whatever it was, I did like it a lot. This one's cool. I always like a good Rakdos deck. Plus, I love Terror of the Peaks, Trumpeting Carnosaur, and Vein Ripper. So it was a nice combination. It was the ability to play with some nice big cards. Being able to copy, it's fantastic. Push-pull, you know, I never really understood why this card was good before. It's okay, six just seems really expensive. But you are pulling two of any particular cards from a single graveyard. But you don't get to keep them. That's the problem. You don't get to keep them. You know, for five, I can bring anything back, period. I might be better with that than push. This is definitely an explosion deck or a card. But it doesn't last more than one turn. So what are you going to do? All right, so still, was it interesting? Yeah, I mean, I also appreciate the fact that this was mostly rotation proof. So this is something we can continue to play for the next year and add to as we get more cards in future sets. All right, so let's add that up. Was this deck competitive? Barely. Was this deck fun? For the most part. Was it interesting? Yeah, pretty much. So I'm going to give this deck I'm going to give it an A minus just because I felt that it wasn't as competitive as I would hope. It needed the ramp, but I didn't feel like it was ramping on card draw, but not on mana. That was, I think, the problem. If somehow we can shoehorn a little more treasure or something in here, that would be fantastic. But we'll have to go looking for other cards. All right, so if you decide to play with this deck, I hope that you have as much fun with it as I did. That is all for now. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. From all of us here in the secret underground headquarters of Uncommonly Good MTG, have a great day. In the words of my people, shine on, you crazy diamonds. Later.